It's not over there either.
What? Are you telling me we haven't found it yet?
Yeah, Garen, we've looked everywhere. It's just not here.
And when he says everywhere, he means everywhere. We've looked all over this construction site.
Well, that's just not good enough. What, do you think it's gonna find itself?
Don't be silly, Garen. It's not gonna find itself.
Rhetorical question, Ford. Rhetorical question.
Why did you just say rhetorical question twice?
Well, if it's not here, it's gotta be somewhere. Where could it be?
Well, the teachers on the inside said that it might be in the social studies hall.
Do you know what that means? That means I'd have to close down the entire school. That's the last hallway left.
Yes, Garen, but it's our only option at this point. We don't want to upset he who must not be named.
True. It's gonna have to be done. That's all there is to it. We'll close down the last hall. I'll put everybody in the portables.
What? Are you kidding me? Do I sound like I'm kidding? DeLillo just told me.
But how could they move us outside? It's crazy.
Yeah, seriously, how could this happen?
I mean, Garen wants to speed up the construction and everything just to get things done quicker.
I have no problem with getting things done faster, but not this! This is getting out of hand, Michael!
Alright, well, what's the deal? When are we moving outside?
By the end of the day.
Alright, well, let's hear what DeLillo has to say about this. Hey, Chloe, get me DeLillo. You'll know where to meet us.
I know, it sounds crazy.
Crazy? This is worse than crazy!
I guess Garrett just wanted to move things faster. I heard this rumor, but you know, it's kind of fishy.
DeLillo, what do you mean?
Okay, well, I heard this rumor where your teachers are going into the construction area. Like, you know, Miss Silberman and Miss Cohn, like sneaking in and out.
What? Why would they be doing that?
No one's really sure, but the weird thing is, the teachers always seem to come out really agitated and nervous. Like, a heck of a lot more than they normally are.
What do you think is going on, DeLillo?
Alright, look guys. All I know is something really weird is going on, and as the SGA, you guys need to take care of it.
Alright, thanks, DeLillo.
DeLillo, is everything okay?
Yeah, man. You look kind of sad.
It's just been a long, tough week. I mean, my period 7 AP Euro class is filled with a bunch of idiots, and with all this construction news and stuff, I'm just worn out.
You know what could really help you sort through these tough times?
What?
Orange mocha frappuccinos!
Crazy falling apart.
I know, it's so frumpy now.
Yeah, and these portables are really dangerous. With all this construction, there's like rusty nails and broken glass all over the place.
Dude, I stepped on a nail yesterday.
I can't believe Garen did this to us, man.
I'm Miss WJ. How could the SGA let this happen?
They failed us.
Yeah, they're laying the school erode before our very eyes. We just can't trust them anymore.
Next time we see them, we'll put them in their place.
You know guys, DeLillo's right. We really need something about this modernization. WJ is falling apart.
Yeah, Michael, you're right. But there's kind of something I've been meaning to talk to you about.
What's up?
Well, I'm taking this girl to homecoming. But I kind of want to take Rafi's sister.
Oh, nice.
Oh my god.
What do you think I should do?
She's well, you know, a freshman.
Well, Rafi's sister is cute and all. But I mean, whoa.
Yeah, you guys want to go to Cadeva?
Sure.
All right, let's go.
Let's do this.
What's going on? Who are you?
Are you sure we should do this?
Yes, we have to. We have no choice.
Who are you people? The science department?
Yes, the science department. We are also known as the Order of the Phosphorus. Protectors charged with the task of protecting the Sorcerer's Mitt by Walter Johnson over 300 years ago.
Wasn't Walter Johnson only born 120 years ago?
We're science teachers, not math teachers.
Okay, but what do you say about the Sorcerer's Mitt?
When Walter Johnson retired from pitching for the Washington Senators, he left with more than just fame and honor.
What do you mean? What did he leave with then?
Walter Johnson took with him a mitt more powerful than anything ever before. The power to give its beholder whatever it desires.
And when Walter Johnson died, he understood that this mitt had too much power for any one person to hold. He knew that if in the wrong hands, much evil could be done. Before leaving this world, he buried it where no one would ever find it, in the depths of Walter Johnson High School.
For years, people have come looking for this mitt, but no one has ever found it before.
And you have this mitt? What does it have to do with me?
Don't you get it? That's what all this construction is about!
Dr. Guerin realized it must be buried at Walter Johnson. When he realized what he was up to, we, the Order of the Phosphorus, removed it to keep it safe.
But how did you know where it was?
When Walter Johnson buried the glove, he entrusted a small group of people with its location should it ever need to be recovered. Since then, this group has expanded and become known as the Order of the Phosphorus.
It's only a matter of time before Dr. Guerin realizes that we have the mitt. We are sure that if he who must not be named gets his hands on it, we will be doomed. The mitt is better off destroyed than in the hands of evil.
He must not be named. Who's that? Dr. Guerin?
No!
It's much more complicated than that. He is an evil that can't even be described.
But wait, doesn't the act of not describing something constitute a description in of itself?
No, because by the action of deeming an object indescribable, the object has no description.
But isn't being beyond a description a hyperbole, thus deeming it a description via the use of figurative language?
Enough! We're not English teachers, and I think we're being followed!
They already found us. This is happening quicker than we realized. We need to get you out of here. You must save yourself.
Michael, you have to destroy it.
But how?
You must find the Bat of Godric Healy. It's the only weapon powerful enough to destroy the Mitt.
The Bat of Godric Healy? Is that the thing Mr. Healy's always carrying around?
Exactly. Oh, and take this.
Why a banana?
When the time is right, you'll know.
Quick, Michael, get out of here! Disapparate now!
And then I said, it's obviously a Pierre della Francesca.
How do you do that? You're like a comic genius,
so
honestly.
Funny. He's actually like the funniest guy I know.
I know. How does he do it? Who is it?
It's Michael Schwartz.
Michael Schwartz.
God, not again.
He always disrupts our special time.
I know. I love you too.
I love you more.
Are you into GW yet?
Not yet.
Not getting in.
You'll never go to college.
Is that him again?
Didn't he just get kidnapped though?
Probably pick it up.
Yeah.
Hey, Michael.
Yeah, hey, Marcelo. You'll never believe what just happened to me.
Let me guess. In some crazy society just kidnap you and tell you what Garen's really up to. Were you then in a high-speed car chase and had to escape?
Well, yeah, actually, that's exactly what happened. Listen, I don't have time to explain. Meet me at WJ in 15 minutes. And make sure you get the Bat of Godric Healy.
The thing that Mr. Healy's always carrying out with him?
Yeah, that thing.
Okay. We're on our way. Guys, we need to go WJ. Now.
It's locked.
Back up, I'll be
one. Oh, Mora!
I've been waiting for you. They're on the field. Go!
Go!